Now write down next heading, Kinetic Theory of an Ideal Gas. The chapter name is Kinetic Theory. We are learning Kinetic Theory of Ideal Gas now. Then we will be learning Kinetic Theory of Liquid. Then we will be learning Kinetic Theory of Solids. Right now we are learning about Kinetic Theory of Ideal Gas. Please write down. So, I am going to find out the basic property of ideal gas in terms of the velocity or the kinetic energy of the molecules. For example, pressure, I am going to define in terms of its velocity. Okay? I am going to define its energy in terms of the velocity, temperature in terms of velocity. Okay? Then I am going to describe specific heat also in terms of the kinetic energy. Fine? So these things we are going to derive assuming the behavior is kinetic in nature or it is because of the velocity. Alright? So assuming that the molecules or the ideal gas equations, ideal gas atoms or molecules are like rigid small balls that are moving in the air. So what do you think the pressure exerted by the molecules will be because of? Pressure on a wall, suppose there is gas here, pressure on this wall will be because of what? Because the molecules are coming and hitting this wall. Isn't it? So according to kinetic theory, the pressure is exerted because the molecules are giving momentum or transferring the momentum to the wall. Because of collision, the pressure is there. If more number of collisions happen, pressure will be higher, or velocity of the collision is higher, pressure will be higher. Simple. Okay, so let us try to find out how much will be the value of pressure in terms of the velocity of the molecules of the atoms. Okay, so I am going to take a very simplistic scenario. Let's take a cubical room sort of thing like this. Draw this. Are you waiting for me to tell that draw? Then you draw. Now I am going to place coordinate axes over here, x, y, and z. Okay? Fine. Now, suppose this room is that cube. Okay? And let me highlight this particular face. This particular face lies in which plane? ZY or YZ plane? Are you getting it? So let's say this is that plane. This wall is that plane. Getting it? Now, if a molecule is coming and hitting this wall, then only pressure will be exerted. Right? And if molecule has to hit this wall, which direction the velocity should be?
Perpendicular.
Perpendicular direction, there has to be a small component of the velocity. And what is that direction? X direction. So there has to be a velocity in the x direction for molecule to hit this wall. What I am trying to say is, suppose this is YZ plane, this. So a molecule can't just go like this or like that. It will never hit this wall. It has to have some component of velocity like this in order to hit the wall. Otherwise, it will not come closer to the wall. It will just keep on going like this. Right? So only the velocity in the x direction will matter. Are you getting it? And when the atoms or molecule will hit the wall will exert a force and the molecule will also exert back the same force. Which direction the force will be? in the x direction, perpendicular to the plane. So which direction the momentum will change? X direction. Are you getting it? So if molecule collides with this wall, the momentum change will happen along the x axis. So I don't need to care about the momentum along y and z axis for this wall. Okay? So please write down the pressure. The pressure on the yz plane. The pressure on the yz plane will be due to the pressure on the yz plane will be due to the momentum of the will be due to the momentum of the atoms along x axis. It's a very commonsensical thing that molecule, if it has to hit, has to have velocity in the direction of the wall. Okay? Now, if suppose a molecule of mass m and velocity vx comes and hits the wall, with what velocity will rebound? Same velocity backwards now, because it is elastic collision, isn't it? Negative vx. So initial momentum is this, final momentum will be minus of mvx. So changing momentum will be 2mvx. I am ignoring the negative sign, because negative positive depends on which direction you take positive. So I just take the magnitude of change in momentum, right? So whatever is its momentum along x axis, double of that will be the change in momentum, because it is elastic collision. Any doubts here? Okay, but then this is the momentum because of just one molecule. And of course, it will have a collection of molecules, multiple molecules will hit. So I can't just find pressure because of one molecule's collision. I have to find out the pressure because of all the collisions that happen. Alright? So suppose small n denotes number of atoms per unit volume. And assuming the atoms or molecules are distributed uniformly across, you need to tell me how many number of collisions will happen in delta t time. In delta t time, how many number of collisions will happen? Assuming Vx is given. Vx, you can assume that all the molecules on an average have the same velocity along x axis. So how many number of collisions will happen? Assume that cross-section area of the this plane is given as A. That is also given. In delta t time, how many collisions will happen? For one collision, this much momentum transfer. So that I have to multiply with total number of collisions. That is why I am finding how many collisions in delta t time. Ajay, tell me, in delta t time, will all the molecules be able to collide the wall or not? No. So suppose particle's velocity is 2 meter per second. Can it reach the wall, which is 2 meter away, in less than 1 second? No. Getting it? Similarly, in delta t time, only some amount of molecules will be able to collide. Okay? So if, let's say, in delta t time, a molecule can travel, how much distance in delta t time it will travel? On an average, in x direction it travel Vx delta t. This much distance it can travel. So if a molecule is away from this distance, will it be able to collide? No. Right? So let's say Vx delta t distance is still here. So then I will draw a wall like this, and then I will find out the total volume of all this. So how much will be the volume between this wall and that wall? Vx delta t into A. Right? So the volume will be Vx delta T into A. So if a molecule or an atom is inside this volume, then it will be, it may be able to hit the wall. This is the volume, so number will be that into number of atoms per unit volume. Are you getting it? So number will be n into Vx into A into delta T. Now there is something wrong here. Tell me what it is. Huh? No, that is taken care of. When I say average velocity, it is taken care of.
All the molecules won't collide at different moment.
That is fine. One will collide in 1 second, other will collide in 2 seconds. That is fine. I am saying there is something wrong in the expression itself. Fundamentally wrong.
The dimension is just fine.
Okay, the hint is the velocity is random. That assumption is not valid when you write like this. What?
Not all velocities.
No, that is taken care of. We are taking the average of all.
Perpendicular to
the. What do you mean?
They might not all collide with the
right. Exactly. So half of it, because it is random, half of it will go in positive x direction and half of it will go to negative x direction. Are you getting it? So total number of collisions will be this divided by 2. It is random, right? There is no preferred direction. All the molecules with Vx velocity only will not be able to move this way only. Half of it will go this way, half of it will go that way. That is why I am taking half. What? Why half? Because it is random, there is no preferred. Because there is no preferred way they will move, exact half will go this way and half will go in another way. Any other doubt? Statistical. It is based on the, have you done chapter mathematics probability? Have you done probability? Probability is like random, it is like chance, right? It is like almost equal number of girls are there in the planet and boys, isn't it? So it is because it is a random event. It can be a girl or it can be a boy. So it is driven by probability. Same thing here. Because this random, this equal chance that molecule will go this way or that way. So that is why I am taking half. Any other doubt? Okay. So this is the momentum. This is the momentum change in one collision. In this many collision, total change in momentum will be how much? Please write down delta P total. Will be this into that? Any doubt? Let's go. 2mvx multiplied by nvx a delta T by 2. Got it? 2 and 2 gone. So delta P total is equal to nmvx square A into delta T. Okay? Now take delta T on the left hand side. So delta PT divided by delta T. This will give me what? Force. This is the force. Fine. So I've got the average force exerted because of the collision. And that force doesn't depend on delta T. Alright, so this is the force. Pressure will be what? Force divided by area. So pressure is force divided by area. This is equal to N M Vx square. So we have successfully derived the pressure in terms of the velocity of the molecule. But this is not the total velocity. This is the velocity only along x axis. Now it is very difficult to measure exactly the velocity in x axis, but on an average total velocity you can measure. So I will try to write this equation in terms of total velocity. Can you do that yourself first? Can you write down this expression of pressure in terms of total velocity V? So we have already found out that Vx square is equal to Vy square is equal to Vz square on an average. Alright? And total velocity square is sum of these three. This can be written as 3 times Vx square. So from here Vx square will be V square by 3 on an average. Okay? And hence pressure can be written as 1/3 N M V square. Now instead of V, I'll use U because I'm going to use V for volume. Okay, so we have got the value of pressure. What is small m? Small m is what? Mass of what? Mass of a single molecule. Small m is mass of single volume. What is small n? Number of molecules per unit volume. Per unit how much volume? 1 meter cube. It's huge. So small n will be a big number. And small m will be a very small number. So big number multiplied by a smaller number will neutralize. Okay, any doubt? No. So this is the definition of pressure in terms of velocity according to kinetic theory of ideal gas. Now, can you find out the temperature in terms of velocity, or let's say not temperature, let's say kinetic energy of a molecule. Kinetic energy of a molecule can you find out in terms of temperature? The hint is use ideal gas equation. PV is equal to mu RT. Find out the kinetic energy of a single molecule in terms of temperature. If you do it yourself, you'll remember it. So try to do it yourself. Get it? The hint is you have to use PV is equal to N and V. Okay, I do it now. Did you get this? Kinetic energy K is 3 by 2 R by Avogadro number into T. Who got this? Let's derive it. one third. Stop talking. Pressure is one third NmVu square. What is N? Number of molecules per unit volume. So I can write it as capital N divided by volume, small n, this into V. This number of moles, how can you write in terms of number? Number of molecules divided by Avogadro number. Okay, this into R into T. Okay, so V and V, oh, there are M into U square also. V and V gone, N and N gone. So one third of M into U square is equal to R divided by Avogadro number into T. So half MU square, which is the kinetic energy, is equal to 3 by 2 times R divided by Avogadro number into T. Getting it? R divided by Avogadro number is referred as Boltzmann constant. K. Boltzmann constant was discovered before gas constant. Any doubts? So we have defined pressure as a function of the velocity, and we have in a way derived the temperature also as a function of the kinetic energy, isn't it? What? Bol. Same. If you say y is equal to x, x is also equal to y. So we have got kinetic energy as a function of temperature, or since it's a linear equation, I can say temperature is also a function of kinetic energy. What does it mean? Change in kinetic energy will happen only when temperature changes. Or only when temperature changes, only when kinetic energy changes, change in temperature will happen. So there is direct correlation. If temperature doesn't change, kinetic energy doesn't change. Fine? Alright, any doubts? Anyone has any doubt? Okay. So basically, kinetic energy of one molecule is 3 by 2 K into T. What is the potential energy of a molecule? Zero. Potential energy is zero. The total energy is what? Kinetic energy only. Right? So please write down, total energy is equal to kinetic energy plus potential energy, which is K only. Kinetic energy only. Okay? Fine. Now tell me, for 1 mole of gas, if the change in temperature is delta T, if temperature changes delta T, then how much will be the total energy change of the atoms or molecules in a gas? For one molecule, how much will be the change in energy? 3 by 2 K delta T. So for one atom or molecule, I keep on saying atom, then molecule, molecule, it is same, okay, as in the fundamental constituent of it. So one atom has total change in energy as 3 by 2 K delta T. Okay? So for 1 mole, how much it will be? that into Avogadro number. One mole has Avogadro number of molecules, right? So for one mole, this into Avogadro number, how much that will be? K into Avogadro number is what? R only. So for one mole, it will be 3 by 2 R delta T. Now something very important is coming. Is this change in energy is also change in internal energy? Is this change in energy also change in internal energy? What it is? Yes or no? What is internal energy? Sum of kinetic and potential energy of the atoms and molecules, and this is what it is. So this is also equal to change in internal energy. And what is change in internal energy formula? NCV delta T. Here N is what? 1. So this will be equal to CV into delta T. So CV is how much? 3 by 2 R. Okay, so we have got the value of CV, specific heat. So we have derived the value of specific heat also using kinetic theory of gas. The CV is this, CP will be 5 by 2 R. What is the assumption here? Tell me. See, even if you take n number of moles, it will be coming out to the same number. What is the assumption? The assumption, please write down. The assumption is the gas is monoatomic, single sphere, moving left, right, center like that. Okay? It is a single sphere or monoatomic gas. That is why half mv square is kinetic energy. Otherwise, you have to write half I omega square also. You know what is half I omega square? If you learn rotate, like for example, fan. Fan is not going anywhere. Fan is there only. Does it mean the kinetic energy of fan is zero? Because its velocity is zero. It has a kinetic energy, right? So kinetic energy due to rotation also will be there. If I take diatomic molecule, it will rotate without going anywhere. It can rotate like this and like that. So there will be kinetic energy because of rotation as well, which I have not taken into account. I have said half mv square is kinetic energy. I have not taken into account the rotation. But when it becomes monoatomic, sorry, when it becomes diatomic or triatomic, then I can't ignore the rotation. Are you getting it? Fine, so that is the assumption here. I am assuming it is a monoatomic gas. Alright? But why can't a single atom can rotate, a sphere can rotate na, like this? Then why am I ignoring that? Because it is very small. Negligible size. That was the assumption. It's like a point. Point can't rotate. If it is a bigger sphere, then I can say that yes, it can rotate about its axis, like Earth rotates. Fine? Right?